obviously, we know that in the fashion world, there are a lot of events, there are a lot of gigs and all that kind of stuff. But I feel like when we're talking about small businesses, they kind of have in the back of their mind, okay, we might fail, so we need a plan B. Does fashion kind of run that way? Or how do you even prepare for something like this?
I think no one can prepare for something like this because it's totally unprecedented. And everyone in fashion, like in every other industry, is taking things day by day and trying to see how they can function and survive. I think one of the big misconceptions that maybe even boutique owners have is that I think that they're actually personally in a lot better of a situation than a large department store. Boutique owners have the ability to run their operations a little bit more individually and with their own mindset.
The PR people, the planners, everyone who puts these things together.
Sure.
What do they do?
Talking to a lot of different people. I just got off the phone yesterday with a friend of mine who is the main fashion financer behind all of the top brands, literally. And their whole, you know, goal right now is to try to help these designers who had orders placed for spring collections to get delivered into the stores. Now these stores are saying, we don't need them anymore. If no one's gonna be coming into our stores, we don't want them. The next concern is for designers who don't have clothes that are relevant right now. Christian Siriano, known for mainly his evening wear, has now really repurposed his whole business strategy and is having his sewers actually create masks that people can use, right, who need them in the medical fields and beyond. New York Fashion Week in June, the rumor is that it will definitely not go on, which I imagine will be true. But in September, while I do think that we'll be able to get back to some sort of, normality, you know, this last season, I mean, I was just talking to my friends, we were packed in these shows like sardines. They fit, you know, up to like 1,000 people in these tight rooms. We're all in tight elevators together. Will that ever happen again? I'm not sure.
We know we walk into a store, and especially right now, you're like, oh my goodness, they have swimwear out. You know, it's so cold in Chicago. How can they even possibly have bathing suits out? But that's how fast fashion moves. And it's always, I feel like, a season, a step ahead.
Right.
Can we even talk about the future?
I have a hard time talking about it. I was interviewed on a radio show and they said, oh, what are the trends going to be for summer? I said, well, will we be let out of our homes over the summer? Because that really shapes the nature of what we're going to wear, right? Designers design based on where we're all going, what we need to buy clothing for. On top of it, in a time where the economy is so bad, we all need to save our money for things that we actually need. We can only celebrate fashion if we have other things. And the main concern that I have in general for anybody who follows me or anybody else is for people to not feel alone. And that's something that's very easy to feel, because even if you are at home with your boyfriend, your mom, your dad, your siblings, whatever, this is still so much more isolating than you can ever imagine. For me, it's just about creating a space to bring the expertise of other people into an open, friendly space of conversation and to help people feel like you can still be entertained, you can still have a positive outlook, and there is some sort of a light at the end of the tunnel.